If that's true, William, one more time, hit that for us. Dude, there's no way.
Look at that. I mean, that's... There's only
the rim butt, I keep telling him to hit. He's hit it every time.
There's only one explanation for that.
Is there a dark energy in here with me? Shit.
Hopefully. And that's yellow light. What is yellow and what are the colors?
It's heavy. Oh boy, there it is.
Satanic?
Yep.
There we go. We can't have those type of foul satanic coming out of there.
It's probably getting close to 3 o'clock.
Oh. I'm gonna come right by your marker. Yes. 51. 51.
Dude.
I'm by his marker.
And that's going off?
We're right here, Willie.
This REM pod's going off. Dude, that one's going crazy.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Day and Night. Tonight's episode is part 2 of the Mountain Meadows Massacre. Now, if you haven't done so already, I encourage you to watch part 1 before watching this video. But if you're not going to do that anyway, let me give you a little history of the Mountain Meadows Massacre. Now, I'm not going to go into all the detail I did in part 1, because that would be insane and absurd, and I'm not that kind of person. But let me give you just a brief history so you know what's going on. In the 1800s, the Mormon religion was persecuted everywhere they went. They really wanted to get away from everybody and be left alone, so they went all the way out to, which wasn't even a state yet, to the Utah territory. Now at this time in Utah, the Mormons felt like there was going to be an attack against them. The U.S. Army was going to attack them for different reasons, one being the polygamy that they were following at the time. They actually built a militia this time. They weren't going to take it anymore, and they were going to fight back. So they were preparing for war against the U.S. Army. Now, there was a party from Arkansas known as the Baker-Fancher Party. And these guys, all they were doing is going from Arkansas, making their way all the way west to California. They left with a party of about 120 people. They wanted to buy some goods or trade for some goods. Because the Mormons built a militia and they were getting ready for war, they were ordered not to give up their goods as they would need them for war. Now, this didn't sit well with the party from Arkansas. Rumor has it they ran their mouths a little bit. On September 7th, 1857, they attacked this group. Not just the Mormons, but they also got a group of Paiute Indians to come in on it. They attacked this Baker-Fancher party, and the initial onslaught killed about 10 people. And 4 days later, September 11th, yeah, that's right, 9/11, 1857, the Mormon militia shot and killed every man there, and then the Paiute Indians and the rest of the militia attacked the children and women, killing everybody. But the only 17 survivors were children under the age of 7. Everyone 7 and older, man, woman, child, was massacred. They think about 120 people were killed on September 7th and September 11th. And it's known as the Mountain Meadows Massacre. If you're not subscribed to the channel, what's the matter with you? What are you waiting for? Go subscribe. It's free to do so. It's just a click of the button, and it really helps us grow the channel and get seen by more people. So please do that, like the videos, comment, and it goes a long way for us. Thank you. The Mormons decided that was gonna be enough. And on 9/11, like Mark said, they ordered a massacre. What are your guys' initial feelings just being out here?
I feel calmness. I could smell the,
yeah,
just the meadows right here. But even up in later years, they were actually dug up bones still. Just knowing that they were brought here, this meadow.
So Mark, you're thinking this is where they separated them, and so they brought the women here while they were alive.
They were.
This is where they massacred them. Yeah. This is where things are gonna get trippy, I think. Dude, it's still going. Thing hasn't stopped.
Gotta catch it.
Stop this.
Did it say stop this? Stop this.
But I think it meant keep going. For wonderful toys. Can you be quiet for 1 minute? I said Christopher! Is there dark energy or evil energy that was attracted to this site because it loves tragedy and it loves death and sadness and sorrow? So everyone knows we're in Utah. It is about 1 a.m. Cat ball.
I think it's rain, huh?
Yeah, yeah. These are going off like crazy. Dude, are we about to experience like a Ghostbusters?
Dude.
She said look behind.
Red pot over there again. Again.
Wow.
Red pot in the corner. Red pot in the corner.
Cat ball.
Cat ball by Rocky. Sarah, were you the mother? Dude, that's a lot of thunder.
This adds to it. Behind you.
It's one way to make us leave.
Okay, we're back.
Back, everyone.
Prostration.
Whoa, hey now. Who's over there? I wonder if they're just taking all the energy from it because... Oh my gosh!
That's never seen that before.
Yeah! What in the hell?
And it's gone.
Were you taking all the energy from that? Dude, I want to see if it still works. That was crazy! I'm not kidding, I just changed the battery in that.
Wow.
That's crazy.
So we've had a Sarah, Joshua, a Jessica. Just wondering if any of you could turn on this flashlight to show that you're here and with us so we can communicate with you.
Dude! What the hell?
That's crazy.
So spirits, we're back. In case you forgot, my name's Nick.
Chris.
Mark.
And you tried to get us out of here with your little rain antics. Didn't work. We're back, baby. Cat ball behind Chris.
Whoa.
No rain. But we're definitely back and hey, we're here to talk. Talk to us, baby. We'll do some EVPs. Four. I have heard that we can still hear the screams of those that were massacred.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace, yes. Should we be inside these gates or these fences or should we be outside them? I'm gonna use my sweet binoculars to look out here across the meadow.
Natalie, they are coming.
Who's coming?
Cecil.
So far I've got about 4 members of my family.
I have a bad feeling about this.
You do? What if one of us has to go out there by ourselves? Is that a better feeling for you? Is that a good idea? Did he just growl?
Yeah.
Rock, what's the matter?
I have something near.
Look at the ways.
Yeah.
What is it, Rock?
Come on, Rock. What is Roxy?
Dude, he's being weird. What is it, buddy?
Animals can pick up spirits better than
energy. Energy.
Nothing's down there.
By the way, I should probably ask, are there skinwalkers out here? Is that something we should worry about?
Agreed?
Oh, snap. So if you died in the massacre, if you died out here, can you tell us your name?
Definitely.
Okay.
What are you hiding from? Are you just playing games with us?
Number 10.
Number 10? Uh-oh.
Hey, that's the second time 10's come up.
I know. I was just reading this thing to see if that was...
Rocky's still fixated on whatever's underneath the metal plate.
Other side.
Other side.
Look at the one on top too.
Was it going off?
Yeah. It sure is. Look at that.
Oh. Who's up on top there?
Knocking on the wall.
Huh. Wow. Now we're talking. Can you guys tell us who's doing that?
What's your name?
Evil is near.
Said evil is near.
Wow. This rampant's going nuts.
I know.
Willie.
Hi, Willie.
Is there a Willie over there?
William?
Willie, were you killed in the massacre by the Mormons?
Show it.
Show it? Willie, if it's you touching the REM pod, can you touch it again when I count to three? One, two, three. Dude. You guys aren't close to that, right?
No. And you counted.
Willie, if you like that game, let's try one more time. This is for Willie only. One, two, three.
Whoa!
Dude, Willie.
Willie's learning how to use the rampart.
It's a trap. Is that not Willie? Is there a Willie on those names behind you?
Watcher.
It said found.
Oh my gosh, I went right to William Cameron.
No, are you serious?
Oh my gosh. Straight to it.
It said found.
Oh my gosh, I went right to William Cameron.
No, are you serious?
Oh my gosh. Straight to it.
Willie, if that's you, Willie Cameron, can you set that off again?
Holy cow! Okay.
What is happening?
Ask him how old he is.
I believe Willie's here.
Willie, how old were you when you died? Tell us.
Someone keep a camera on this.
I know how old you were. Can you tell us?
Is all the battery sucked out of that REM pod? Like if you get close to it, will it?
It's dead.
It's like dead, huh?
Oh my gosh. Like the other one.
I wonder if we put the battery from the other one in this one.
We could try.
I have more batteries, but I left them in the car. Willie, if you're still with us, hit it one more time. Sweet. Okay.
Hi.
Willie's here.
Willie's here.
William, how old were you?
What?
Can you give us your age, William?
He said tastiness.
Joan.
William.
Joan. Who's Joan? Should we find Joan's name?
How old were you, William?
Joan, if you want to try to touch the REM pod, do it now.
2 o'clock.
Okay, maybe Joan's not as good.
Do you think they could give us signals without saying anything?
Left here.
What do you mean?
Well, the magnitude. Because William, no, it's not. William was 51 years old when he died, and I looked down here and it said 51.
On your phone?
Yeah, the magnitude meter. Now it's down to 47. So I was, it was just kind of weird.
I think you could. I think they can. I think they can.
How old
try
were
to
you?
Communicate different
can
ways.
Can you show us? Can you? Can you bring it up to your age? You had it before.
That's pretty trippy.
Yeah.
Is that you confirming that that's your age? That that's you?
Yeah. Now it's up to 50.
If you're doing 51, William, hit it one more time.
Put it up to 51,
dude.
William.
Dude.
50. 50.
Hit 51, baby. While he does that, I'm looking for Joan.
12 o'clock.
I just saw John. I saw Sarah.
How old were you?
Sarah, John, Joel, Jesse. Jesse.
Jesse's over there.
Yeah.
No spirit.
No spirit. Nancy, James.
Hit 51, please. 50. Come on, you did it before.
Susanna.
Just a little more, Willie.
You'll kill?
I'll
Why?
Come over here. I'll come over here by your marker.
Mary, Lorenzo.
I'm going to come right by your marker. Yes. 51. 51.
Dude.
I'm by his marker.
And that's going off?
You should be scared.
We're right here, Willie.
Why should I be scared?
I'm right there. Now it's back down to 30-something.
Wait, all the way back down to 30?
Yes.
No way. That's a big difference.
No, now back to 51. It's at 51.
Dude, that's crazy. That's really unbelievable.
Yeah.
So turn on the light and then locked. What does that mean? Locked.
You were so close.
I was so close? John, Richard, oh, was I so close to finding your name?
Sign.
William, there's another William right here.
Okay.
And another William.
So maybe the 51 was his way of saying this
that,
one's...
That's the one I am, yeah.
And who's that corner he's playing with?
That's insane. If that's true, William, one more time, hit that for us. Dude, there's no way.
Look at that.
Which one do you hit?
There's only
the
one
red button. I keep telling him to hit. He's hit it every time.
There's only one explanation for that.
Number 10 again. What does that mean?
They're trying to tell us something.
I'm in the house.
You're in the house? Like a rapper? Like you're in the house or like... You went in the house.
Energy.
Energy. You need more energy? I bet you do. You've done a lot for us.
Leave.
You leave?
There it is.
It's going off again?
Morning.
Captain John Baker.
Thank you, William.
Abel Baker.
Weirdo.
They called me a weirdo. They do that a lot.
It's the top of the monument. Yep. Thank you. Look at that.
The only 10 I've seen so far is on Nancy Dunlap.
Dude, it's still going off over there.
That's the top of the monument. Thanks. Whoa.
I saw that, Mark. That lit way up.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Wow. Okay.
What's that noise? Do you hear that?
Yeah. Hey, have we had a John come up yet on a name?
No, but there's like 1,000 of them, huh?
Yeah, because I was wondering.
Remember we had Jonathan?
The energy is rising.
The energy's rising, boys!
I just wonder if one of these unknown age ones is trying to tell us how old they are.
Dude, again over there.
Dimension.
Dimension? Could you not?
Is there a Nancy here?
Nancy? I'm a Nancy.
That seems had better days. I just saw a raindrop land right there.
No.
Okay, I'm going down past the memorial on a walking trail to where I assume they had the circle of the wagons. They had their wagons in a circle to defend off the Indians. Oh, do I have a flashlight? Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I got a flashlight.
I am peaceful.
What did you say? What did you say? There we go. What? There we go. That's a little better. It's raining again. It's okay.
It's like so quiet and calm though.
Yeah.
Dude. Well, there goes.
What is your name?
My name's Nick. Dude, that's going off. Dude, cat ball behind you. Walk in front of that gate again. Set that off.
This ramp out going again.
Okay, I'm walking forward. I'm going to put this other meter up on the rocks, okay? Cat ball over here. Dude, it's like they're starting to play with us again and bringing the... It's like they're bringing the rain again. Dude, this isn't going off, dude. Here, 29 victims of the Mountain Massacre. Chris, the number 10. Here, like 29 victims of the Mountain Massacre, Mountains Meadow Massacre, rendered on 10 September 1999. September 10th. And this was going off when I was reading it. Is that the 10?
Yep. They may have wanted us to see that. The only other 10 I've seen is on Nancy.
You read this one?
No.
Here lies the skull of a child victim of the Mountain Meadows Massacre, recovered by relatives.
Maybe the 10 wanted just to see that over there and recognize the skull.
Stay away. It's pretty weird, dude. Look at that, baby.
Whoever skull that is, we recognize you and sorry for what happened.
Asparagus.
Glad we
Asparagus. When's the last time someone brought their dog out here to visit you guys? Not enough, right? I knew it. It's a nice thing to do. Curse. Is there a curse for me to be standing inside the wall? Just said curse.
I mean, can you even read those things from outside though?
No.
Yeah, so...
Let me ask this. If it's bad for me to be in the wall, touch the rampod, anyone. Okay, I think I'm good.
You're good. Oh.
Not so much. Dude.
Hello, can you hear me?
That scared me, dude. All right, let's let go of the REM pod. We're trying this again. Is it bad for me to be inside the wall? Hit the REM pod damn it. That's like a different color too. Is there a dark energy in here with me? Shit.
Oh boy. And that's a yellow light. What is yellow and what do the colors mean?
I don't know, but it was like purple a second ago. Does the dark energy want to kill me? Touch the REM pod if yes. Hmm.
Definitely.
Okay, you can stop. If you'd rather kill Chris, touch it now. Uh-oh. If you want to kill me, go purple. Okay, you don't want to kill me anymore. Think I'm good. That's green. That's a lot, though. Is that Mark way up on the hill there with the light? Dude, it just said Jessica again. What the hell? Microphone.
So where was that Jessica, Nick? Over here?
Standing yeah. Standing beside you.
Oh. Hi, Jessica. I'm just gonna look at your stone here.
Dark soul.
Is Jessica a dark soul or are we the dark soul?
If it's Jessica, hit the REM pod.
Smudge home.
What? Smudge home? If you're talking about us, is the dark soul, hit the REM pod.
We won't harm you.
Huh. Oh. You will harm us? It said EVP. Should we try EVPs? The voice recorder?
Yeah.
God, where did I put it? Help? Who needs help?
Where are you?
I'm on the wall. Where are you? If you're sitting close to me, touch the REM pod next to me. Oh, there you are. Dude, somebody's Johnny on the spot with the REM pod.
Yeah. That was purple too.
Oh, dude. It's like so quiet though.
You have to calm now.
What do you think Mark's doing out there?
I think he's looking for that trail that goes and shows something else. I don't know what it's supposed to show.
Coming up to the Siege Memorial.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we hear you.
10-4. Who's out here? Can you speak to me? Ever remembered in honor of those who rest in this field, they were innocent and died in unjust attacks that began on September 7th, 1857. They were defending their friends and families who buried them before leaving the protection of their camp. The other victims of the Mountain Meadows Massacre who lie in unknown graves, rest in peace and be assured you are remembered.
Six spirits.
Seven spirits around me? Did you die here? Are you still here? Please talk to me.
Brandon.
Hello, Brandon.
In your car.
I can feel you. Please talk.
Okay.
Are there still five?
EMF.
We have that. Okay, I'll breathe. There's so much pain out here. So much chaos.
Evidence.
Who killed you? Who was it that killed you? There is someone around me I could feel. Who's around me?
Out that way?
Oh, dude, I'm getting a lot of bugs all of a sudden.
I know, there's a million.
Dude!
Oh, boy.
It's trying down there.
He has left.
He has left. Wow, who were we talking to?
Or was it talking about Mark?
I don't know.
2020s.
It said like two different things.
2020s? He has left.
Accumulate. Okay, dude, the bugs are...
I know.
I feel like some light went off on the site. Like, didn't the lights go out and now it's just our camera lights? And that's why the bugs are now here? Were there lights on?
Yeah, that the light on that flag goes on and off.
Oh.
But these lights, if you're in one spot for too long, the bugs just come.
That's what it is then.
Mark, do you mind a grave?
It's a memorial to those who were killed out here. It's pretty cool. I think this is where the wagon circle was.
Did you hear that, Chris?
Yeah.
What was that? Dude! What was that?
What?
That was loud. That was like a bang on like a tin can or something, like bang. Did you not hear that? Dude, I know my audio got that because that was loud. Same noise. Do you hear that? Flagpole? The rope? Damn it.
Alright, Grandpa. Whoever's right. Touching it, what do you want to say?
I think we should try to speak with the spirit box.
I'm gonna walk down here. I have a feeling this is...
She was killed.
Who was killed? What's your name? Was it over here? Are you still here?
Altar.
Altar? Is that the altar? I feel... Oh boy. This was the place.
Seven.
Seven who? Wow, this is where it happened. They came in on horses. Oh, wow. Are there still bodies buried here? Seven were killed here. That is true. That is true. Seven were killed. Scott. Seven were killed from the 7th to the 11th before they massacred him. Seven. If I remember correctly. Well. I feel this is it. I'm in a bag. Were seven killed here? I feel sad.
Cold.
Feels good. It's a little cold, but because of the rain.
All right, here we go.
Poorly.
I'm gonna put that one in my office.
Is there anyone here with us?
Oh, you mean Estes?
Well, we don't have headphones, but... just stopped. This REM pod's going off. Dude, that one's going crazy. Dude.
This is the place. I need my flashlight. Is this where you circled the wagons for 4 or 5 days? Here, there's... is this where it happened? 7 died here.
Monsters.
Who is here with me?
Dude, like... I like being here, but it's getting late and still got a good drive back. That's weird though, right there.
Yeah.
That's bizarre. Gory. Bridge, should we go back to the bridge that's over there? Maybe we should.
What is your name?
I've told you my name so many times. It's Nick. What is your name? Should we stay here or should we go somewhere else?
We should go somewhere else, touch the rampart again.
I think we should go somewhere else.
Well, this is where he was. This is where the wagons were in a circle.
Wagons were in a circle, and I had 7 come over my meter here. And that's how many died from the 7th to the 11th.
That's wonderful news.
And right after, I had a name, Scott, pop up.
Scotty, Scotty, Bobody, Banana, Fana, Fobody, Bee, Bye, Bobody, Scotty.
Number 5! It's like so calm over here. Like, it's just so quiet now.
Alright, I'm not taking that path back. I'm gonna come through here. I want you to talk to me if you can. I'm gonna head toward the memorial. Sorry that your trip ended here. But I bet this is a beautiful meadow when you got here. Full of flowers. heck's that? What is that? Oh, just a reflective sign. Okay. Alrighty. Is this where your wagons came through?
Follow.
What? What did you say? Follow, okay. Am I going the right way? I feel like I'm led over here. There's no snakes. It's 7 o'clock again. What does this sign say? Rock cabin. 200 yards. All right. All right, let's see what this is here. There's a cabin here. Shirley. A federal grand jury indicted 9 more militiamen. Those many more died in future arrests. About 50 other militiamen were involved in the massacre, along with an unknown number of Paiute Indians. Only one, John D. Lee, was brought to trial and convicted. Almost 20 years after the massacre, federal officials took Lee to the scene of the crimes. Not far from this very spot, he was executed by firing squad.
I say we either go to a different location or we just go home. I don't hear any screams. You can't. There's too many, like, frogs.
Headstone.
Frogs and crickets and...
Yeah, it's like... Is that what you thought you heard? Any chance you want to climb that rock again?
Yeah, I'll go grab that. It's easy.
I haven't seen a catball go off in a while.
I remember there were pictures. There's a picture of him that I think Nick's going to pull up. In the meadow. There's a picture of him that I think Nick's gonna pull up in the meadow sitting on his coffin. They brought his coffin out. He was probably over in here. Gosh, I don't remember trees. But he had a choice of being hung or shot by a firing squad. He chose the firing squad. They brought him in, sat him down on his coffin, blindfolded him, and I'm sure Nick is going to pull up a picture of him, a picture of him sitting on his coffin. Unwatermarked. Martha and Shirley.
Don't say it.
Whoops. Don't say what? Is this where it happened? Tell me where it happened. Tell me. I'm standing in the spot. This is it. But John D. Lee... interesting fact, John D. Lee was a relative of General Robert E. Lee from the Confederate Army. He was pretty much just a sacrificial lamb for the Mormons to kind of diffuse the situation and make everything all right.
You're in danger.
No, I'm not. Why are we in danger? If anyone's in danger, it's you. You're dead. Do you have a flashback of a Paiute Indian? Is that why? I'm sorry.
I'm up here to get stuck.
That was below the belt. Why would we be in danger? Do you ever think, like, hey, maybe we shouldn't have talked shit to the Mormons? Did you ever think that?
Incredible though, what is, it's like a ledge. Oh my gosh, what the heck?
Inside.
Inside what?
The well, number 10.
Well, that number's been pretty prevalent all night for some reason. But yeah, this, well, I was at the spot of the,
died in this area.
Wow. Did John Lee die in this area? I know he did. It was right around here. I could have walked right by the spot. John, are you here with us? Here with me? I'm sorry that you ended up being the chosen one. It was right out here. So I guess I'm close. Should I walk out here a little ways? Can you tell me? Alan?
It didn't turn out so well, did it? Anyway, I'm not being mean or taking sides, just kind of calling out the obvious here. You're like, next time I'll think about what I say. Wait, I'm dead. First person on YouTube to be completely insensitive to the Mountain Meadows Massacre. I'm kidding. I'm just trying to get a rise out of you. It's not working.
I will speak.
Go ahead, speak. You said we were in danger, so thought I'd have some fun with that. I mean, you're the one trying to be all tough. Kind of like you were back in the day with the Mormons. Okay, that's enough. Instead, I'm listening to you. I'm just kidding, by the way. That's probably not funny at all to you. It's kind of funny to us. But I understand not to you. But I hope... Dude, you hear that going off, the claps? That doesn't go off very often.
It's gotta take some.
Someone's gotta walk in front of it.
Can't be wind, right? Never.
No.
Hateful.
Did you say hateful? Seriously though, Mark was really talking shit about you guys, saying you're cowards. So, it's Mark.
Stop this.
Said hateful, incorrect. Stop this. All right, I'm sorry. It was Mark. Sorry.
Was it right around here? Am I close? Tell me, am I hot or cold? Where was John executed? Wow, I feel... Jeez, I don't know.
Walk right.
Okay, walk right. Okay, wow, what is this? There's a hose. I'm walking right, okay? Cabin. Walk right. It said to walk right. I turn right. There's something ahead. Something up there. Look at it. I'm coming up to it. Okay. Okay. All right, well, just gotta... Oh, wow, you took me to a restroom. Thank you.
Satanic.
Oh, boy, there it is.
Satanic?
Yep.
There we go. We can't have a ghost hunt without Satanic in there.
It's probably getting close to 3 o'clock. So, that's what I want to know. That's kind of my big question of the night. Does something like an event like this draw Satan and satanic things? I've heard it does, and I kind of feel like that would be correct.
Probably.
So what if we just have a one-on-one talk? Me, you, and the REM pod. If you really don't think I'm funny, set the REM pod off. No, I was saying if you think I'm funny. Okay, you don't have to touch it so hard. Pwah, these bugs suck.
10 o'clock.
Why did you say the word satanic? 10 o'clock is like... All right. Whoa. We hate you. I get it. I can understand how you said move location. Like, we hate you, get out of here. Move.
Okay.
We will, but what we want you to know is we don't really feel that way. We're just trying to stir things up to get a response out of you. Oh, dang. Did anyone do like satanic rituals up here, you think? What is that red light up on the hill?
I don't know.
That's where where we went first, right?
I think so. Yeah.
All right, well, me and Chris and Rocky, we're going to get out of this spot and go find Mark. Would you like that? Hit the REM pod if you really want us to leave. Dude. Every time I ask, it hits it. Okay. Do you understand? Hit the REM pod if you understand. I was just joking. It's just kind of trying to be funny to loosen you up. Oh, you know that. Okay, one more thing. Stop so I can ask another question. Do you secretly like us even though you're telling us to leave? I knew it. They like us, Chris.
There might be like one of them that doesn't think it's funny, but the other ones, they all realize it's pretty funny.
Yeah, there you go.
And we just came here to visit you. You know, we're not.
We're going to try something else. We're going to put the REM pod on the ground to see if the kids want to play with it. That's me, everyone. That's me. All right. Are there any kids in this area? little kids like Johnny, Joey. Now, if there's kids here, please just hit that antenna. Like, try to grab it hard. As hard as you can. That Rocky, good job. Now do it. Oh, there you go, kid. Yeah, yeah. A little bit harder. There you go. That's a grab. Dude, I cannot take these bugs on my face.
I know, dude.
Shit.
I'm gonna have a lot of bug bites, I think, tomorrow.
I'm gonna turn my light down a little bit, so hopefully the bugs, I don't know if it's gonna help. If you're the person whose skull was found, hit that ramp pod. No.
Green means definite.
Okay, so if green means definite, we're gonna ask one more question. Do you like our friend Mark? If you like him, hit red. If you hate him, hit green. That looks like they like him.
They like him.
I thought for a minute it was gonna be the other way because it went green. Oh, uh-oh. Uh-oh, Mark. I feel like maybe somebody loves him and somebody hates him.
I think there's some that do and some that don't.
There we go. Rocky just set it off. Good boy, Rock.
Where is he anyway?
I don't know. That's why I was saying those things. I think I'm all out of questions. Oh, there's Mark.
There he is.
Should we just grab that REM pod and go somewhere else?
Are we about done?
I think so. Like, I don't know what else to do.
I got some good stuff.
Did you?
Yes.
Good.
That cross that was here originally,
mm-hmm.
said, on the cross it says, "Vengeance is mine. I will repay, saith the Lord."
Really?
Yeah.
Me and Chris were up here telling the spirits that you're Mormon and you said all these bad things about them on the way up.
What? Is that why I was getting things like, "Your dad, I'll kill you.
You're mine, mother." But we got like some REM pod communication. I know you were here for a lot of it that I've never seen before on command.
When I was up there asking questions,
just the whole time. What? Like we would say like, "Do this, do that," with the REM pod, and like on command every time. So from what I got, from the feelings I got, and from what we were doing, is I just felt like people were saying, different people were just kind of saying hi. There was nothing evil or bad or scary. It was just kind of, "All right, we'll communicate with you a little bit," but whoa.